Ladies and gentlemen, please stand up for the academic procession. The audience may please be seated. I now request the Pro Vice Chancellor to conduct the proceedings.
I now request the Vice Chancellor to felicitate the chief guest and the guests of honor. I now request the Vice Chancellor to declare the convocation open.
The convocation of the English and Foreign Languages University has been called to confer degrees upon the candidates who are found worthy of these degrees by the university for the year 2016-17. I declare the university's first convocation open.
all the candidates eligible for the degree of the university kindly rise for the oath.
Do you promise and declare that if admitted to the degree for which you have qualified, you will be a loyal and contributing member of the EFL University, and you will, in your daily life and communication, uphold the prestige and dignity of the university and the country? Do you pledge that you will do your best to realize the full potential of your personal competence and strive for excellence in all that you do, and use these abilities to lead, serve, and make our nation a better place? Do you assure that you will faithfully fulfill the duties of the profession that you choose, and you will on all occasions maintain the honor and reputation of the university?
The PhD candidates will now be presented with degrees. I invite the Dean, School of English Language Education, Professor A. Supendran, to read out the names.
Madam Vice Chancellor, I present to you these candidates and request that they be admitted to the degree of Doctor of Philosophy in English Language Education. Mr. Narendra Sarathy. Mr. Ramamuni Reddy. Ms. Kranti Kumari. Ms. Sushma Parvathani. Mr. Vadda Saleh Mohammed Mawari. Mr. Kalamadi Nagendra. Ms. Spurti. Ms. Suman Rani.
Go.
Mr. Deepesh. Mr. Deepak Kumar. Mr. Bansode Amit Namdev. Ms. Vijay Lakshmi. Ms. Valerie Kiran Raj.
Go.
And Ms. Rashmi Rekha Bora.
I invite the Dean, School of Language Sciences, Professor Hemlata Nagarajan, to read out the names.
Madam Vice Chancellor, I present to you these candidates and request that they be admitted to the degree of Doctor of Philosophy in Linguistics and Phonetics. Mr. Shob Ekram. Ms. Anushree Srinivasan. Mr. Satish Kumar Nadimpalli. Mr. Kottakonda Suman. Ms. Priha Agarwal. Mr. N.V. S.N. M. Ganesh Sinisetti. Ms. Soumya P.N. Ms. Neelam Chetri. Mr. Rajender Pondra. Mr. Ramarao Chevila. Mr. Boddu Chandrasekhar. Mr. Deepak Mishra. And Ms. Nilisha Yadav.
I invite the Dean of School of Literary Studies, Professor N. Ramadabi, to read out the names.
Madam Vice Chancellor, I present to you these candidates and request that they be admitted to the degrees of Doctor of Philosophy. English Literature, Ms. Vrinda R. Chant. Ms. Sweta Antony. Ms. Jinju S. Mr. Jay Singh. Comparative Literature. Ms. Meenu Susan Koshi. Indian and World Literatures. Mr. Sunil Kumar. Mr. Wilson Jetty. Mr. Kishan Thingbai Jam. Mr. Shreesha Udupa. American and Caribbean Literatures. Mr. M.D. Suman Prasad. Commonwealth Literature, Ms. Shruti A.P. Translation Studies, Mr. P. Mattaya Yadav. Mr. H.K. Raghavendra. Mr. Guram Sitaramulu.
I invite the Dean School of Interdisciplinary Studies, Professor Dilip K. Das, to read out the names.
Madam Vice Chancellor, I present to you these candidates and request that they be admitted to the degree of Doctor of Philosophy. PhD Hindi, Ms. Parul Christina Khalko. Ms. Asma Banu. Mr. Kale Shakti Raj. Mr. Sontake Sainath Chandra Prakash. Mr. Suresh Pawar. And Mr. Biradar Shivaji Ganpatrao. PhD Film Studies, Mr. Binayak Bhattacharya.
I invite the Dean, School of Asian and Arab Studies, Professor Saeed Jahangir, to read out the names.
Madam Vice Chancellor, I present to you these candidates and request that they may be admitted to the degrees of Doctor of Philosophy in Arabic. Mr. Abdul Shukur Poka, Mr. Muhammad Shakir Raza, Mr. Sayyid Arafat Hussain, Mr. Muhammad Rashid, Mr. Muhammad Kalimuddin. Thank you.
All candidates who have received their certificates may stand for the conferment of degrees by the Vice Chancellor.
By the virtue of the authority vested in me as the Vice Chancellor of the English and Foreign Languages University, I admit you to your respective degrees of Doctor of Philosophy, Master of Arts, Bachelor of Arts, Bachelor of Journalism and Mass Communication, Masters in Journalism and Mass Communication, Bachelor of Education, Postgraduate Diploma, with all the honors, privileges and responsibilities. I ask each of you to prove worthy of the degree throughout your life and uphold the honor and reputation of the university and the country.
All candidates may now take their seats. I now invite the Dean Research, Professor K. Amli Raz, to present the candidates the degrees in absentia.
Madam Vice Chancellor, I move that 75 undergraduate, 143 postgraduate, 44 doctoral and 8 diploma candidates be awarded their respective degrees in absentia. By virtue of the authority vested in me as the Vice Chancellor of the English and Foreign Languages University, I admit you to your respective degrees of Doctor of Philosophy, Master of Arts, Bachelor of Journalism and Mass Communication, Master of Journalism and Mass Communication, Bachelor of Education, Postgraduate Diploma, with all honors and privileges and responsibilities. I ask each of you to be worthy of the degree throughout your life and uphold the honor and reputation of the university.
May I now request the Honorable Governor to award the gold medals to the undergraduate and diploma toppers of the class of 2016. I invite the Controller of Examinations to read out the names.
Sir, it's my privilege to read out the names of the gold medalists of the undergraduate and diploma programs. Ms. Ariba Hidayat of BA Honours English from Lucknow campus. Ms. Vandana Srikumar of BA Honours French from Hyderabad campus. And Ms. Sumaya Mariam of Postgraduate Diploma in Teaching of English from Lucknow campus.
Thank you, sir. May I now request the Honorable President of India and the visitor of the university to award the gold medals to the toppers of the class of 2016 and to the best research scholar of the university.
sir, it's a great honor to also read out the names of the gold medalists of the postgraduate and PhD programs. Ms. Riddhi Saha, MA English from Lucknow campus, who is also the topper of all the postgraduate programs. Mr. Shomo Chaudhary, MA English from Hyderabad campus. Ms. Swati Veena Lakhra, MA Hindi from Hyderabad campus. Ms. Sannati Mori, MA Linguistics from Shillong campus. And now a foreign national, Ms. Yukino Amemiya, MA Japanese from Hyderabad campus. And now the best researcher, gold medal, to Dr. Shirisha Udupa, a PhD scholar in Indian and world literatures, Hyderabad campus, whose cutting-edge research has been acknowledged and applauded by top universities abroad and is adjudged for gold medal. Dr. Udupa has been invited by and funded by 7 universities abroad, including the Queen's University, UK, Duke University, USA, University of Basel, Switzerland, and the Fulbright Commission, among others. This category has been instituted to encourage cutting-edge research by PhD scholars, which has been acknowledged globally. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. I now invite the Vice Chancellor to present a report on the university.
The Honorable President of India, the visitor of the university and the chief guest for this afternoon's function, Shri Pranab Mukherjee ji, Honorable Governor of Telangana and Andhra Pradesh, and also the chief rector of the university, Narasimhan Saab, Honorable Deputy Chief Minister of Telangana, members of the Executive Council, Academic Council, faculty, staff, recipients of the degrees, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, namaskar. It is my privilege this afternoon to extend a cordial welcome to you all. Today is a historic day for the English and Foreign Languages University, the very first convocation of this avant-garde multi-campus university, which was founded with a singular vision of developing competency in language, literary and cultural pedagogies, teacher education and research in humanities in the country. The EFL University stands out uniquely among the universities in South Asia in these specialized areas. The journey of the university has been a memorable one. From its inception in 1958 as Central Institute of English and later as Central Institute of English and Foreign Languages in 1972, and with 2 regional campuses, Shillong in Northeast in 1973 and Lucknow in 1979. In 1973, CIEFL advanced to be a deemed university. And in the year 2007, the university was acknowledged as a leader in humanities university and by an act of parliament declared a central university. It was a brilliant voyage of validation to a central university. However, the challenges of transition needed to be met. The past 5 years have gone into ensuring systems are in place, building a credible international academic profile, and dealing with the dark forces of negativity. The preceding years also went into reinventing and strengthening the foundation of this premier institution by building a strong edifice of educational achievements through administrative reforms, transparent and accountable governance, improved student facilities, career and academic support for faculty, and promotion of research. Hence, the journey took a while to reach this commencement day. Today, we stand tall with our achievements. I am happy to share with the honorable visitor and the distinguished guests that we have been accredited with Grade A by NAC in 2016. After a hiatus of 16 years, we had earlier been awarded the 5-star in the year 2000. It must be remembered here that EFL University is international in academic profile. in its academic profile. We have been pioneers in the cafeteria model of teaching. Our international stature is also reflected in many honors and awards that seek out our students and faculty. It is a matter of pride that our students continue to be recipients of the prestigious Gates Scholarship, Erasmus Mundus Scholarship, and Fulbright Fellowship. Our faculty too continues to receive postdoctoral awards, Raman Fellowship, and Fulbright at prestigious institutions abroad, including the Harvard and MIT. Swami Vivekananda had spoken about the need for a man-making and life-building education. A university must build such a narrative, and we at EFL University strive to create in the spirit of Swami Vivekananda a generation that believes in itself through our 7 schools, 26 departments, and 10 undergraduate, 18 postgraduate, 20 diploma courses, along with the PhD programs across the departments. The university has a student strength of 3,000 and a faculty of over 200. Apart from the regular undergraduate, postgraduate, and PhD programs, the university holds the distinction of building a formidable outreach programs in the areas of consultancy, customized need-based training programs, and translation and interpretative services in foreign languages. These outreach programs directly interface the university with corporate sector, public sector undertakings, social welfare organizations, defense establishments, and other government sectors. The university also serves the educational needs of various states through its skill development programs, such as the District Center Scheme, English Language Teaching Institutes, and Regional Institutes of English. So far, the university has successfully trained over 50,000 English teachers at the primary level through 28 district centers and over 2 lakh tertiary and secondary school teachers through the 17 English language teaching institutes and 2 regional institutes of English in pedagogic training, syllabus design, material production, and training the trainer courses. As global player in higher education in the field of humanities, the university has established linkages with international universities for faculty and student mobility. Collaborative research and co-tutel, joint teaching are also part of our programs. Through the MEA, the university conducts international training programs. Participants from 98 non-English speaking countries are trained by us. Further, the university has trained diplomats from Asian countries in the recent years, modulating the course as per their requirement. The university has also established through the MEA, Ministry of External Affairs, centers for English language training in ASEAN countries, such as Vietnam, Cambodia, Laos, Myanmar, and in Sri Lanka. And we are now poised to open new centers in African countries, such as Sudan, Djibouti, Togo, and Mauritania. With all humility, I might add that the EFL University strives to contribute to India's soft power abroad. Today is the commencement day, a milestone in the life of students and their teachers. As you prepare to launch yourself in the real world, I wish to recall here the words of Steve Jobs, the founder of Apple and Pixar. His advice to the Stanford University students was, and I quote, "Your time is limited, so don't waste it living someone else's life. Don't be trapped by dogma. Don't let the noise of others' opinion drown out your own inner voice. And most important, have the courage to follow your heart and intuition," unquote. As you stand on the threshold of a new life, a myriad opportunities and challenges await you. I hope that you will add to the innovative dimensions of your personality through hard work and diligence in life. Bernard Shaw had once said that life isn't about finding yourself, it's about creating yourself. In your expedition in life, I hope you constantly renew, recreate, and reinvent yourself push your boundaries and emerge as morally grounded leaders of tomorrow. I extend warm congratulations to all my students as you enter the portals of a new life with optimism, hope and energy. I'm sure your journey at EFLU University has shaped you into well-groomed, ethical, value-driven, responsible citizens of India. As we measure our success in terms of our students' achievement today, I am proud to have presented before the Honorable President of India, the graduates, PhD scholars and the gold medalists. To my young friends today, it is not a farewell, but as T.S. Eliot had said, fare forward, and I quote, fare forward, you who think that you are voyaging. You're not those who saw the harbor receding or those who will disembark. Here between the hither and the further shore, while time is withdrawn, consider the future and the past with an equal mind and do not think of fruit of action. Fare forward, unquote. I take this opportunity to thank Honorable President of India. You have, Honorable Sir, as visitor of 126 central institutions, motivated, enthused, guided and navigated the higher education landscape of our country. Your emphasis, Honorable Sir, on aspects relating to faculty development, linkages and foreign institutions, industry-academia interface, research and innovation, international rankings, engagement with society have translated into effective outcomes in all the central institutions. We are indeed privileged that you have accepted our invitation to be the chief guest and to deliver the convocation address. Thank you for this honor, sir. I also owe my gratitude to our chief rector and governor, Sri ESL Narasimhan Saab, for his unstinted support to my institution and to me personally. I thank the deputy CM for his encouragement to this unique central institution. Thank you. Thank you all, and Jai Hind.
Thank you, Madam Vice Chancellor. Now, I request the Honorable President of India, the Chief Guest, to deliver the convocation address.
Good afternoon, Sri ESL Narasimhan, Honorable Governor of Telangana, Mohammad Mahbub Ali, Deputy Chief Minister, Telangana, Professor Sunayana Singh, Vice Chancellor, English and Foreign Language University, Professor K.C. Baral, Provisi, EFLU, members of the Executive Council, Academic Council, Deans of Schools, faculty members, distinguished guests, dear students, ladies and gentlemen. It's indeed a pleasure to be here today for the first convocation of the English and Foreign Language University. It is a young university. This is your first convocation, although you have a rich history of teaching and teacher training since its inception as the Central Institute of English, which was established as part of the vision of our first Prime Minister, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, in 1958, and later as Central Institute of English and Foreign Languages in 1972. Regional campuses were established in Shillong and Lucknow to extend its reach before it became a central university in 2007. It is indeed a matter of satisfaction that it has been dedicated to finding solution of the big challenges in language education and preparing students for leadership in a complex world. The university bears 6 decades of experience in envisioning and materializing an educational need for a new India from its renowned city of Hyderabad, a city that stands apart as a city of poets, painters, artists, and creative minds. A smaller India in itself, it throbs with multiple languages and culture, cuisines and crafts of its own. It's a multifaceted city with much cherished historical legacies and flourishing visions. Out of the harmonious symphony of the old and modern in the city of Hyderabad, this university of international repute emerged due to her work and collective energies of people with international reputation. Today, EFLU stands out among the universities of South Asia and specialized complementaries in the areas of language, literacy, cultural pedagogies, language sciences, teacher education, and research. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, I am happy to know that the university has built a significant research profile in language and literary studies, cultural and interdisciplinary studies. The university's extensive and intensive exploration in research range from natural language processing, classical and Bhasha literatures and cinema studies to the philosophical studies on one hand and new experimental researches in cultural theories, performance studies and media analysis on the other. I am informed that in addition, upcoming domains of research at the university are forensic linguistics using speech recognition for forensic purposes, digital humanities, archiving and documenting digital databases for cultural memories and cultural creations of the country, and cognitive science approach with the focus on acoustic phonetics, language disorders, and language processing. Ladies and gentlemen, with its expanding research profile, EFLU can play a significant role in reorienting higher education in the country as well as in other emerging nations. It should be possible to develop educational packages from school to university level for training and for collaborative teaching and research. Recognizing the seminal role played by the university and assisting productive expansion of its founding vision, the Government of India has entrusted EFLU with several groundbreaking and important projects such as National University Student Skill Development, National Literacy Mission Authority, and massive open online courses. Acknowledging the eminent role that the university evinces in teacher training and educating, the Ministry of External Affairs entrusted the university with the international responsibility for training diplomats and designing training trainers training program. I am told that these Edigard Centers of English Languages training have been set up in ASEAN countries, and 5 new centers are going to set up in African countries. I am happy to know that the university had initiated outreach programs such as university industry interface and mutually beneficial dialogue with the public sector undertakings, social welfare organizations, governmental agencies, media house and private educational institutions. On this august occasion of your first convocation, as we celebrate the impressive achievements of your university, let me share with you some enduring reflections that ought to guide us in advancing our vision in education. To my mind, knowledge must pave the path of life, and living must essentially encompass, pursue the path of learning. From times immemorial, the continent of Asia, and Southeast Asia in particular, opened up noble paths of learning. Wherever Lord Buddha traversed, seeds of knowledge sprouted and flourished. Nalanda, after Takshashila, held the beacon of light very high for over a millennium across lands and seas, and welcomed drifting speakers of knowledge and provided them with a lasting resting place. Today, sustaining and reinvigorating higher education in India as well as in other parts of the world has become a major challenge, especially in the public institutions. Challenges exist for such institutions both from outside and inside. At least 4 distinct factors impinge from outside as well as inside on the administration of an institution of higher education appear to me. These are escalation of costs of learning, narrow pragmatics that is market-oriented, fast-track skill acquisition as the sole goal of learning, allure of invasive dominant communication system, depleting attention span, and on corrosion of trust. Any attempt to build or reorient higher education in such a situation requires administrative acumen. Administrative strength and sensitivity removes hurdles in the path of learning and allows academics to thrive as this university has displayed. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, cynicism is an easy alibi to evade responsibility. Any institutional failure is dependent upon enabling the faculty, students, and the staff to overcome cynicism. One way of achieving this is making everyone a stakeholder in collaborative institution building. Immersive teaching supplemented by intensive research alone can advance the vision of the university in generating new knowledge, sharing it with everyone, and extending its horizon. It is important to recall that the singular feature of Vidyadan, that is, this country has extended on planetary scale, was aimed at attaining happiness for everyone. early teachings of our Upanishads, Sarve Shikhina Bhavantu, Sarve Santu Nirama, Sarve Bhadrani Pasyantu, Makoschi Dukkabhak Pabe. This sloka should be the driving impulse of any conception of education in any period or place. In a contemporary period, I remember some inspiring words of US President John Fitzgerald Kennedy, how he inspired the young graduates. I quote a few words. Too many of us think it is impossible. Too many of us think it is unreal. But that is a dangerous, defeatist belief. It leads to the conclusion that war is inevitable, that mankind is doomed, that we are gripped by forces we cannot control. While strongly advocating for peace, he said, our job is not to accept that our problems are man-made. Therefore, they can be solved by man, and man can be as big as he wishes. Unquote. On this celebratory occasion, I wish all those who leave these portals of this prestigious university carry its legacy as they move on to attain a happy, prosperous and meaningful life. I wish them all success, Godspeed in their future endeavor, but always remember, as human being, as part of the human society, and that human society can never be confined to any geographical territory. You are to serve man. To serve man is to serve the humanity and your continuity. With these words, I thank you, wish you all success, dear students. Jai Hind.
Thank you, sir.
The audience may please stand.
I now request the Vice Chancellor to declare the convocation closed.
I declare the convocation closed. Thank you to my eminent guests. Thank you, President Saab, for this, for extending a gesture that motivates my young students this afternoon, and also inspiring my young teachers. Thank you, sir.
Please remain standing for the national anthem. Ladies and gentlemen, the retreat of the academic procession, please remain standing.